Good morning to all the participants. Good morning. Today, I'm going to introduce our guest speaker, Mr. Supriyo Datta, delivery leader of NSEIT Limited, Mumbai. He has 20 years of experience in project program management, business analysis, functional design and software development with thrust in project delivery of various sizes. Primarily in the domain of robotic process automation, insurance, FMCG, mobile applications, and e-governance application packages. He is a key player in analysis, development, and implementation of strategic business plans, ensuring organizational growth, targeting maximum profitability and cost effectiveness. He has won CIO Bold 100 Award in 2008 and Engineers 100 Award in 2009 and PC Quest Best IT Implementation Award in 2008 and Diamond Edge Diamond Award in 2009. He is currently associated with NSEIT Limited Mumbai in the capacity of delivery leader and lead RPA consultant. I welcome you, sir, for this session. Over to you, sir.
Thanks a lot, ma'am, for the introduction.
Welcome, sir.
Thanks a lot, ma'am, and good morning to all of you.
Good morning. Supriya sir, good morning. This is Roshankar. Participants will join one by one. Today is Saturday. Maybe we can, people will be joining one by one later, sir.
Want to wait for another 5 minutes or so? Is that good enough?
Okay, can you wait 5 minutes?
Yeah, sure, no issues, absolutely no issues.
Okay, yeah. Balaji sir, in the WhatsApp group, participants are seeing some technical issues, please go and solve them. What is this? Waiting in the lobby. Hello, them.
Sangha, sir.
Somebody is waiting in the lobby.
Billy, I am calling. Papa, bedroom is calling.
What? Can you
hear me? Papa, lobby. Na waiting for lobby. Or lola. I am skip. Cut it. I am. I am bedroom is calling. Lobby. Illa. Bedroom. I am. I am. Cut. Lea. Screen. La.
Check the WhatsApp.
Yeah. எனக்கு லாவி எதுவும் காட்டலையா வரணும் மொபைல் சங்கர் சார் யாருமே எனக்கு லாபி காமிக்கல.
Did you check the WhatsApp group?
What? எனக்கு எதுமே காமிக்கலை சங்கர் சார். நான் யாரும் இல்ல சங்கர் சார், எல்லாமே லாபி கிளியர் பண்ணியாச்சு.
Okay. Supriya sir, can we start?
Yes sir, we can definitely start.
Okay sir, fine. Yeah.
So good morning to all of you. Today, first of all, I'd like to thank Shankar sir for reaching out to me, and I'm privileged to share across my thoughts as well as what the industry is doing on IPA, that is Intelligent Process Automation. While my brief background has already been shared across, I would like to highlight few things which might help you during this session in asking me questions, or beyond this session also getting in touch with me to understand any specifics that you may have related to this topic. So my journey into RPA has started approximately 4 years back. So if you notice, the complete RPA is approximately 4 to 5 years old, the complete technology. But with the pandemic now in the, from March onwards, people are more or less looking forward towards a lot of automation. They want to do away with the people who are manually handling the things. So what's exactly are the areas which this RPA, IPA thing is impacting? What is this jargon all about? Or what is, there are a lot of myths also that I'll be sharing across, because being close to the industry, it brings a lot of expertise at my end to share across, where I can actually tell you what's theoretical and what's practical. This might help you in your journey while you are taking up the RPA, IPA related discussions at your end. While I am sharing across a deck, and I'll be sharing across few videos, and these videos are actually taken of the live scenarios or implementations that have been done. These This slide presentation and the video has been prepared to bring an understanding and a clarity about the whole topic. Any place, if you find that you want a little bit more in-depth knowledge about that specific area, you let me know. If I can cover it during this session, it will be well and good. If I cannot cover, I'll definitely share across more relevant details with you separately. So the topic related to intelligent process automation, if you notice, there are three very critical words which are there in this sentence or in these. So we are referring to intelligent as a separate word, process as a separate word, and automation as a separate word. Now, the most critical thing amongst all these three words that are there in front of the screen is process. Without a process, you cannot apply intelligence to the process, neither can you apply your automation to the process. I'll briefly cover what is the market size of this intelligent process automation that we are looking at, but please do always keep in mind while we are discussing these topics that more than 85 to 90% of the implementations fail or they are unable to give an ROI because the processes, underlying processes, are not proper. Now, what do we mean to say by underlying processes are not proper? There are processes which people pick up for automation which will not give an ROI, but it is simply for the ease of their daily work. That is not a good process for picking up for automation. So frequently when we visit our clients, we come across a very simple question. So what's a good process for automation? So briefly, we will touch base on what's a good process for automation. Where did this intelligent process automation come from? Why should you do an RPA? Few of these details, some of the team members who are currently joining the session may be already aware about. But while I am touch basing all these areas, there is a specific intention that we need more clarity on these specifics before we jump into the bandwagon of an RPA, IPA, and more prominently during this pandemic, there is a new term which has been coined, which is related to, so Feb 2020, Gartner gave a new term for this industry, hyper automation. We'll be briefly covering about hyper automation also, what exactly is this hyper automation. These all form a part of the process automation. You call it RPA, you call it IPA, you call it smart process automation, SPA, or you call it hyper automation. Everything comes under process automation. We'll briefly be looking at the tools also that are being used very prominently in the industry. And what are the giants, software giants actually doing about this process automation or intelligent process automation? Please feel free to interact wherever you feel that pace is very slow or it is becoming redundant. Please do let me know so that I can change my presentation accordingly. So any organization, when they opt for a IPA, RPA, or a hyper automation, few of the things that are the very base of any of these journey. There are a lot of systems currently in the market which are age-old systems. Some are on still AS/400 kind of environment. If I want to automate those systems, is it really feasible? And if it is feasible, then how do I do it? Is the question that comes in the mind. So there are tools and technologies for automating such systems so that you have no dependency on specific skill sets who handle those kind of environments. So automating these kind of age-old systems is something that was one of the needs for automation. Every budget, so again, the budgets will start for the Indian companies. Jan, Feb, March is the budget season. The first priority would be, how do I ensure that the business is more? However, IT budgets are less. Again, a need for automation. When we talk about IT budgets, one of the most prominent areas people look at, how do I reduce the employees' how do I ensure with the reduction of the employees also, I still manage my output, quality, everything. Now, reduction of cost is a pressure which is by default there because of the pandemic. So if you notice, there's a huge amount of requirements coming out from the industry related to automation. Customer demands. Customer wants us to service them 24/7, 365. This is not new, but is every business equipped to service the customers 24/7, 365? Because you need that kind of manpower. So there again comes a great value add from automation. And yes, the most important thing is standardization. Mr. Shankar is a very good intellectual person, and while he does his work, there is 100% accuracy. Supriyo is not so accurate. He does his work, the work is completed, but every time with a 10% error rate. Is there a standardization in the process? Human beings cannot be standardized, processes can be standardized, and such standardized processes can only be fit for automation. Any queries over here, I'll take a pause over here. Any queries, why do you need to automate? The first basic thing. Okay. Obviously, whatever I discussed in the previous slide, you get the business benefits out of automation. So if you notice, we discussed that, can I automate the things completely? So there is a term in the industry. Straight through processing, STP, end-to-end automation. There are very few processes where we can do an end-to-end automation. Most of the processes still require a human intervention at some point in time. So these processes cannot be categorized under an STP. However, these processes are eligible to be transformed into an STP process post automation, where some more changes are brought into this process, which is process reengineering, and we make it an STP process. So that's why on the right hand side, if you notice, reduce manual effort. We have not said eliminate manual effort. Banking and insurance, majorly they require a maker checker concept. They do not depend only on the maker concept. So even if I program it automatically, there has to be a checker to see if there are any error cases which the software could not process. Somebody has to look at it manually. Always available. Yes, there are Christmas vacations coming. There is Holi vacations coming. So I will take a leave. Human beings are prone to do this. Now business demands 24/7, 365 days. Complete attention towards your customers, which can mostly and only be done by the software, not by any human being. How well is your business doing? There are multiple reports which are generated across the industry, across various domains. Do I always get my reports online at the right time to take the decision? Despite of so much amount of computerization, digitization, you will find that CEOs or the CXOs are still challenged to get the right piece of information at their fingertips at any point in time. And these are the challenges which an RPA IPA solution tries to eliminate. Any point in time across the globe, anywhere you are, if you program the solution in such a manner that anything and everything which is matters to you for taking a decision in your business, the details are always available at your fingertips, on your mobile devices, on your laptops, to ensure that you take an immediate decision. Of course, with manual intervention, there are multiple times manual errors creep in, which is cost to the business. I need to redo those things. In automation, you eliminate all these issues. These figures are taken from, if you notice, third quarter 2020, as latest as October and November. The Gartner has published these trends in the industry. The RPA investment again is more than $1 billion in this year also, despite of the pandemic. So that showcases the kind of requirement in the market, kind of need, and the kind of investment that is going on in the market across the globe for RPA, IPA solutions and its implementation. Now the question comes, somebody may ask you that, is this a new topic? No, automation has been there for decades. For the more than one decade, at least it has been there. This is the second decade completion, in fact. But still, what is new in this automation? So the power of automation was always restricted to certain areas where programming skills were predominant. Now with the tools and technologies which are much more advanced, there are multiple players. We'll just cover that in the next slide. There are multiple players who have come into the market who are giving you this particular power at your fingertips. And that is why now automation is mandatory and it is no more a choice. A very nice analogy that has been published by Gartner as recent as in the month of November, in fact. This is the journey that Gartner has been tracking for the last few years. Now, why this particular slide has been presented over here? To showcase that if you notice in 2018, there were pure play RPA, robotic process automation vendors. And if you notice in the month May 2020, Microsoft, a software giant, has suddenly got into automation. Does Microsoft has its own automation capabilities? Yes, it has its own automation capabilities. Why has it acquired another company, Softomotive, which is also a RPA service platform provider? Why has it acquired that? IBM acquired another automation company. Now, these are all software vendors. They can build something of their own, but they have acquired some companies which are already there in the market. Now, this is the beginning of the story of something that we discussed in the very beginning, which is called as hyper automation. As per Gartner, the logical progression from RPA, next stage is IPA, and the third stage is hyper automation. As per the definition of Gartner, what is hyper automation? If you notice over here, 2018 till 2020, there are individual companies like UiPath, Automation Anywhere, Blue Prism, SAP. They are providing their own services to automate your processes. It may be insurance process, it may be banking process, any other process. They are providing you a platform. So what's different, what Microsoft, IBM are trying to do? A very simple thing. IBM has got multiple products of their own. Microsoft has got multiple products of their own. With the acquiring of these technology companies, they are trying to build the automation inside their products. So basically, if you want to automate something in SQL Server or in .NET or in Excel, you do not have to purchase anything from an UiPath or Automation Anywhere. Microsoft is giving you a platform which has got inbuilt capacity capability for automation. So what happens in an enterprise? You've got maybe not less than 100 different products which are working in an insurance company or in a banking industry, in a bank. So all these have got inbuilt capacities, capabilities for automation, and the giants like Microsoft, UiPath, Automation Anywhere, what they are now providing is a layer that will connect all these dots, and your complete enterprise will be automated. This is what is called as hyper automation. You are not doing automation in silos. take a pause over here. Am I clear with the concepts that I'm going to discuss or I'm highlighting over here? Any suggestions, feedback?
We are clear, sir. We can follow.
Okay. So now, in Indian subcontinent, in the last few years, the top three contenders who have been able to make a place in the automation journey of most of the corporates are Automation Anywhere, UiPath, to some extent Blue Prism. Blue Prism is a product which is coming out of UK. Most of the UK based companies by default will opt for Blue Prism. Very slowly they have set up their headquarters in India also, and they have started operations. However, Automation Anywhere and UiPath are the top contenders in this particular space. We will briefly look into what are these guys doing, why they are a part of the IPA journey, hyper automation journey, or are they really a part of it and they are just making a marketing gimmick. We'll just have a quick look at it. As per one of the magic quadrants, UiPath, Blue Prism and Automation Anywhere are the top leaders, which you can see from this. Now, there is this particular product which is called as Antworks. It's a Singapore based company with its offices in Pune. And the uniqueness of this particular product also we will cover. It is not about the product. It's about what all things can we do with the automation platform. What all things should we look at when we are automating anything, because all these platforms are relevantly costly, they do not come cheap, and how do we understand which platform to take and what kind of ROIs are we looking out from these kind of platforms. We'll very briefly touch base on those. So in the Indian subcontinent, you will come across prominently these two. Recently, Blue Prism has also started coming up the curve, and Antworks. Softomotive already taken over by Microsoft. Some of the companies are still using it. So any of these service providers, now previous slide was more related to which are there in the market. Any of the service providers which are trying to provide services in RPA, IPA and hyper automation, what are they trying to provide? Most of the companies lack one very basic thing, and which is very critical: the automation strategy and the roadmap. What to automate, when to automate, how much to automate, these all are covered in the automation strategy. Not every process or every work item can be automated. So there is something called as a feasibility study, which is supposed to be done. If you find that after the feasibility study, this particular process is not a good candidate for automation, do not opt for that particular process. Of course, the business case and the ROI. Now, the best thing, if I ask anyone that you've got 5 employees in your organization, what is the ROI? The person will tell you something which would be more in line with that per hour, the productivity of this particular person on each person is an X amount, which is again a money. What is the ROI of a software bot? If I take a bot, the bot is available for me 24/7, 365 days. If I do not feed the bot enough amount of work to automate and give me the results, I am wasting my money or losing my money. So I have to ensure that the bot which I have brought in or I have implemented should be engaged 24/7, 365 days to give me the value for money. All these products that we are discussing or all these platforms which are there in the market, they have got only one licensing policy: yearly renewal. You have to renew it every year. If you don't, it will stop. One of the major challenges, if I want to shift from one service provider on one platform to another platform, can I shift? You can't. So before investing a penny into any of these platforms, we need to be 100% sure that this is one of the right platforms for my digital journey or for my RPA journey. Here, the business case ROI, business case clearly highlights which cases or which processes are to be taken up for automation. How much amount of manpower saving, cost saving are you expecting from that particular process if it is automated? Thumb rule, any human being, any task, if they are doing manually, the bot, software bot, globally acceptable rule is it should take less than 50%. So 50% is the benchmark. So if I take 20 minutes for completing one record entry into the system, the bot will take 10 minutes max, but it cannot take more than 10 minutes. So 50% savings should always be there, considered while we are considering ROI. Process assessment. This particular section has got a huge focus now. If I just take you back to the previous slide, over here, if you notice, UiPath has taken up a company by the name of Process Gold. Automation Anywhere has recently started providing services out of the box in their platform where it can do a automated process discovery. This is very critical and very important. Why so? Which process gives me maximum ROI? Which process is a suitable process for automation? These all are done till date manually with the help of the business analyst and the process analyst. Now tools are being made available to help in doing these activities. It also gives a detailed documentation as an output. And one of the very critical elements which we already spoke about is the process re-engineering during this complete exercise. Also, the service providers, they implement the platform, they complete the automation, and they do something which is again very critical, is center of excellence. So automation is a journey. It cannot end immediately after you automate a single process or a set of processes and stop. You have to keep on improving. Otherwise, those processes will become redundant and you'll keep on getting the same ROI. You have to start looking at which steps are redundant in this process and I can eliminate them to get a better ROI without impacting my quality. The work of the center of excellence, any new tool, any new plugin which is there in the market, which will help my business in the RPA IPA journey. The center of excellence team has to do that activity, suggest the business team and get that implemented. How are these service providers providing these kind of services in the market? They are either providing the services on-premise, they are either in these pandemic scenarios, they have taken the access of those environments and they are trying to provide the services from work from home scenario. And some of these service providers are also picking up the licenses by themselves so that the client is only focusing on the automation. So RPA as a service, IPA as a service is some of the things which are currently being taken up actively in the market. The below box showcases a very quick snapshot of what all things are expected in an RPA IPA journey. It's an end-to-end journey. You select the process, detail out the process. There is something called as an assessment matrix. I will show it to you what exactly is this assessment matrix. RPA, IPA, intelligent process automation. If you notice the wordings used over here, RPA, cognitive or ML processes, machine learning processes. When the RPA came into the picture in 2014-2015, only those processes which are redundant in nature and they have clearly defined steps were picked up for automation. The demand in the market is that my processes are clearly defined, steps are clearly defined, but few of the places I need an analysis to be done by the person or the software bot, and based on the outcome of that analysis, the next step should be defined. Now the bot needs to think. Can a bot think? It cannot think because it's a piece of code. What can I do more to ensure that my bot or the software piece of code starts thinking? I start plugging in AI ML capacities and capabilities into the bot? How do I bring it in? Does everybody knows AI ML? It is challenging. So what I do is I give you certain capacities, capabilities outside the out of the box, basically, where you do not need to know anything related to AI ML modeling or anything. You just feed in the data to the system and the system will showcase the output based on the AI ML capabilities. If the output rendered is acceptable, please proceed to the next step. None of these AI ML or cognitive solution can work without a normal RPA solution. So basically, the RPA solution comes first. It takes the data set, gives it to the AI ML solution. The AI ML solution throws back the data set to the RPA solution. RPA solution then takes it to the next step. That's how the journey works. So you have to decide whether with this particular process is a intelligent process or a normal RPA process. Publish the assessment report. Conduct POCs. I'm again repeating, not every process is good for automation. Somebody tells me that, boss, I have taken a photograph at my shop. There is a video camera installed and there are some photographs which are taken. The bot needs to identify, okay, when my customers are purchasing certain set of items, which are those items the customers are more preferring so that I can keep those sort of items ahead on the shelves for an easy sell. I cannot do it with a normal bot. I even cannot do with any of the solutions available in the market right now. I have to specifically implement an AI ML solution for this particular scenario. Candidate for automation? No. There are multiple such examples. People have come up saying that, okay, I'll give you the name of the customer. News 18, we went to. They wanted that while multiple videos are being played, the bot should be able to identify which all videos are provocative in nature and it should tag them. Or if you suddenly find that the home minister has gone for a visit at a certain place on a specific video, the bot should immediately tag it and it should publish it into the media and all. Good ask. Can I do it via automation? I cannot do it via automation. It requires very specific solutions. So the industry is asking for such kind of solutions from automation. Once you define the RPA roadmap, which showcases which particular set of processes, which departments you need to take first, second, and so on and so forth, you design and develop the bots, productionize the bots, and continue with the RPA journey, set up the COE, and so on and so forth. Any questions on this? There were a lot of things that I just touched based upon. Okay. The most prominent areas where RPA, IPA, and now hyper automation in the next few months or next few quarters would get used is the BFSI sector. In the BFSI sector, which all are the areas where we generally see a huge implementation of automation? If you notice customer onboarding, there are a lot of handwritten documents. Now, again, a word of caution over here. None of the solutions in the market will give you 100% accuracy or even a 90% accuracy on handwritten documents. We'll briefly touch base on something called as you must be knowing about OCR. There are advanced OCRs in the market which are backed up by AI ML capabilities. That is why they call it as the intelligent OCR. So in the intelligent process automation journey, there is a very, very big role play of intelligent OCR. I'll briefly cover that in the next slide. Anybody who is writing nowadays, a lot of onboardings are actually digital in nature, using tabs, mobile phones. They actually capture the client information. But still, there are a lot of places where the handwritten documents come in. And we are continuously challenged by the client by asking that I want this data to be extracted from these documents and to be keyed into my core banking system or core insurance system. Very challenging. Again, repeating, not more than 65-70% accuracy is given. The best accuracy is given by Microsoft Azure currently in the market, followed by Google OCR. PAN card. I need to understand if the person has filled in the application form and the provided supporting documents are the same. So read the data from the PAN card. Looks very simple. Believe me, it is very simple. Most challenging is, how did you get that PAN card information? Most of the banks, they get it via photographs. The photographs have been taken by cameras which have been tilted. They have been taken at any angle, any kind of exposure. Most of them are a second topmost category in which we receive these documents are Xeroxed and then scanned. The quality of the documents is not at all good. So even though I am trying to extract the data from these documents, there is a specific guideline that the document should be mandatorily more than 300 DPI only. They should be clear. There should be no background noise. That means when I'm reading the data, there should not be any black overlay or any other kind of color. Because of these, the OCRs cannot read the data. One of the most challenging and the most sought after areas is application forms, capture the photograph, capture the signature, and put it into a different folder. And that is the most used use case in the market. With even 65% accuracy, people are ready to take it because per hour they are receiving at least 100 to 150 applications for some of the businesses. Loan application and signature verification. So we briefly touched upon a particular product called Antworks. That particular product has got an inbuilt module. You can directly match the two given signatures and it will give you a percentage match so that you can take a decision. Okay, KYC, we briefly covered this. Invoice processing across the globe, intelligent automation is used maximum places for invoice processing. Why? We will briefly cover that and we'll showcase a video also how this invoice processing is done. Now this invoice processing, why it is taken up across the globe? Because it is a standard process. At the max, you will have some labels that will change. But most of the labels, like the name of the client, the shipment date, the invoice number, invoice date remains the same. So I can extract the data using a specified algorithm and AIML algorithm. Now, why AIML in this? Why it is intelligent? Question might come into the mind. It's so simple. The challenge is that across the globe, the number of companies, you can now multiply the number of types of invoices that gets printed. The data is same, format is different. There comes the AIML capacity capability, which helps or ties up with the RPA solutions to ensure that you have got a complete package. Any kind of automation solution, intelligent automation solution, there is a specific phase called the training phase, where you are actually training the algorithm to understand the various categories of documents, what to extract from these documents. Once you have trained the application or the bot, you can now put it onto production. The moment the documents are made available, it will automatically process, extract the data and proceed to do the next steps. Some of the places it may not be able to do so. It will stop and send it into a different queue because it has not been trained to do some exceptional scenarios. So you need to retrain the bot again. Any solution across the globe, which is an intelligent process automation solution, will have these steps. Bank account opening form, a very critical one, travel document processing. Employees, they keep on traveling at multiple places and they have to submit these bills and all. Bills from multiple companies, multiple hotels and multiple formats. The accounts team, they spend nights together to ensure that the data is keyed into the system, accounting system, so that the payments can be made. Easily solvable solution via RPA, IPA. Percentage of accuracy, again 75 to 80%, because majority of the time you will notice all the hotel bills are stamped, paid. And the moment a stamp comes on the top of it, you will notice the problem that I said, noise in the document, because of which the OCR is unable to extract the right set of data. Insurance claim processing. You would never come to know if at all you have applied for an insurance claim. It has processed by a software bot in the background. No human being has even touched your application. ICICI Lombard has come out with this is approximately year and a half back when they automated their platforms for claim processing. they had a clear mandate that up till 50,000 worth of claims, 50,000 rupees worth of claims can be auto processed by the bot. The moment the application comes in, bot scans it, understand as per the rules and regulations whether the application is proper or not, looks into the supporting documents. If everything is proper, it gives an instruction to the accounts team to process the amount. Another very key area where you will find this, flight cancellations. I went on to the airport and there was a flight cancellation, and during the booking I had opted for an insurance cover. There is an API which has been given by the airlines to the insurance companies. The moment there are flight cancellations and the people who have opted for that particular cover, the details are available via that API to the insurance company. Even if you come out, before you have come out of the airport, the amount is refunded onto your bank account, all possible via automation, and has been implemented in the industry. Any questions on these use cases, anything that you want to discuss over here? Okay. I've been continuously repeating what are good processes for automation, why you should not automate everything. Very quick snapshot. I've got an application which after every data entry it throws up multiple set of errors, and these are all messages, and somebody has to sit and say okay to all the messages and then go to the next record. Since it's a human being and there has been no support from the IT, this particular application is being exactly used like this, and I want to now automate the process. So now you notice the frequency of exceptions which are there in the software are on the higher side. So you have got a low assessment for this particular process to be automated. If you say that after every record or data entry, there will be a dialog box which will come, you have to just say OK to it twice and you have to go ahead. It has got low frequency of exceptions and it is a high on the matrix for automation. So exactly like that, repeated processes are supposed to be automated. So I have a process which I only do fortnightly or monthly or every 6 months once I do that process. Is that a good process and the priority process to be taken for automation? No. Do I take this metrics as a guarantee? Again, no. It is just a guideline. Why so? I came across a particular company wherein every quarter they take up a process of 1800 sites to be visited and to check whether the company has uploaded, these 1800 companies have uploaded their financial statements, updated financial statements on the website or not. Very critical, because the report has to be submitted to SEBI and there cannot be any flaw in the report. This particular process was being done by chartered accountants who are actually being paid in lakhs. Out of their daily hectic work, they have to find out this work every quarter to complete this exercise. It is repetitiveness of the process is low, frequency is low, but it is a critical process. It's a time consuming process and there is a good amount of ROI that I can get out of this process. So when we revisited this process, we said that yes, it is a good process to be taken up for automation. If there are no queries onto this metrics, it's just a guideline, I can go on to the next key areas of IPA. Okay. One of my favorite slides, what IPA across the globe will focus on, something you must have heard about, phrase, data is the new oil, because oil is the most costliest across the globe because people use vehicles and so on and so forth. Now with so much amount of data across, so data is the new oil. So what is this data all about? Currently, whatever we have been discussing, that data which is to be extracted from PDFs, which are searchable PDFs, data which can be extracted from normal Word documents or specific Excel documents. These are all very structured data. Even if I make a software out of it, I'll be able to put all these things into structured tables and everything. But every time, is the data going to be like that? Data which is coming from, let's say, a voice sample, data which is coming from Twitter, Facebook, any other place, is not going to be structured data. And today, not 80%, in fact, 90% of the data is unstructured data. When we say unstructured data, what we want to extract from the data remains the same, but the data from which we want to extract this information will come in various different formats. And it can be in any of these formats which are highlighted. Some of these formats are highlighted over here. It's very difficult for one solution to extract the data from these various kinds of sources. Here, nothing other than an AI ML solution will come into the picture. So most of the IPA that we look into today has somewhat or the other built-in AI ML packages which help the software bot to actually analyze and pick out the right set of information that we target to extract. RPA is a very simple journey. There are very simple steps to be taken, but IPA, as I just discussed, the unstructured data, there are lot of problems in getting the information out of this unstructured data. So if you notice, I said voice samples. So customers have call centers have got these recordings, and we require a bot to review these recordings, convert that voice into text, and then analyze the text. How do I do that? I have got speech recognition algorithms which help me doing this. Natural language processing. The way I am speaking, the bot should be able to decipher this. It should be able to understand whether I am giving a proper feedback, it is an aggravated answer, and should be able to take the case to the next level and immediately ask the supervisor to take a next set of action. Natural language processing. There are multiples of predictive analytics. If after the first few sentences of the customer, the bot is able to target, okay, this particular customer is a repeated customer, he was an irate customer last time, and we have not been able to close the request that he has put up, and again he has come back. I am doing a prediction that again this is going to be an escalated one. I put up a human being to the task rather than taking up the task by the bot. This decision can be taken up by the bot, and a lot of call centers have now started implementing this solution, wherein a part of the predictive analytics is actually used by the bot to take some futuristic decisions and target the particular request to a specific set of queue, priority queue, where the human being is actually physically present to attend to those requests. In all these discussions, if you note, semantic intelligence, which is a part of NLP, is again a very critical component. While I am speaking, with how do you know that whether I have not used words which actually hamper your product in the market, or I am irritated on the services of your company? So semantic intelligence is something that it will bring across these particular things to the fore. And very, very critical component amongst all these, and which is the most frequently used, is the computer vision or image analytics or the OCR. Now you notice image analytics. Now we always actually do most of the time data analytics. We extract the data and we do the work on that. There are requirements which come out where we say that the image has to be analyzed, and the various items which are, let's say, a photograph of a person has got multiple items on that particular photograph, which the image analytics software can actually analyze and distinctly specify if a person is wearing a blue colored shirt, a black colored trouser. All these can be specified automatically and can be sent for further processing to the analytics engine. I'm sure you must have heard about this company called Myntra. It's a online fashion website. Or what they have developed in-house is, the moment you have gone and registered yourself on their site, it will tell you as per your age, gender, and as per the festive season, which is currently going on, which kind of dress you should pick up, which kind of shirts and trousers you should pick up. Now that looks a bit weird, bit surprising, but yes, they have got an AI ML engine, and today the designers, they have got their own designers. When I say designers, dress designers, Myntra has got their own dress designers. The software system, based on the purchases made by the people online, gathers which exactly is the pattern that the people are opting for, and based on that, it also proposes which is the kind of dress that should be designed for the mass market and which will give you more profitability and saleability. And they have tested this particular AI ML solution for the last 2 years, and it has been so successful that today their designers only design what the algorithm tells them to design, and that is only put up into the marketplace. And this particular solution is provided as a service to Shopper Stop and other such brands. We'll quickly cover the intelligent automation aspects, where it can be utilized in insurance. One of the areas we briefly covered is the claims, where we can utilize it for assessment. You can definitely utilize it for a business acquisition. So if a person has put up an inquiry, then this particular chat bot or a voice bot is sometimes linked with automation, but it is more related to natural language processing, which is the NLP technology. The bot on top of it, it's just a layer. So it's not strictly speaking a part of the intelligent process automation, because there is no process in that. You got questions, answers, and you go straight forward. There is nothing more than that. It's more of a NLP. So here the customer service experience is good, because you, whenever you are going onto the site, you get a feedback and you are able to take a decision, or your requests are attended to. I'll give you an intelligent process automation aspect of this whole process with the latest technologies that are in place, and why voice bot or a chat bot is not a intelligent process automation technology, but the latest one which I'll show you is actually an intelligent process automation technology or an implementation aspect. OCR again prominently comes into the picture, because the person who has put up an inquiry will put up the documents and everything. It will go to the underwriting and the policy servicing department. The decision can be taken by the bot and can be forwarded to the underwriter based on various parameters and dynamics that has been captured in the document. Then it has to go in. If you notice, again, legacy system, most of these companies are using AS/400 based systems. That is why legacy systems. Business process management is one of the critical tools used in hyper automation, which will be connecting all of these. So business process management solution, if you notice again, the keyword that we had briefly discussed in the beginning, straight through processing. Why not 100% straight through processing? Because lots of places, the decisions will only be forwarded to the underwriter. The underwriter will then take a manual decision. So it is not an STP. Okay. After that, the scoring. Now claims, if there is a claim, then the assessment score will be given, whether this is a proper claim, and below a particular amount of scoring, the particular claims cannot be processed. And then an RPA. Now, if you notice, after all these, the RPA is coming over, because if there is a review and approval process, I put up a claims application. If there is a review and approval process based on the assessment score, only then the reviewer will come into the picture. Otherwise, the decision can be taken up by the bot and the people can go ahead. And after all these processes done, there is an inbuilt analytics also. Now, most of the platforms, RPA, IPA platforms, they give an inbuilt analytics platform also, which can be utilized, or the data from all these platforms can be provided to an existing analytics platform, and the necessary output can be generated for various business decisions purposes. So if you notice, from business acquisition, underwriting and policy servicing, claims processing to final billing, everything is covered under one roof and can all be automated, and this is the automation layer which is there. I'll just briefly showcase some videos now before I go into the last few slides. Is the slide visible with the title as interactive forms?
No, sir. It is still on intelligent automation in insurance.
Okay, let me just redo it.
Yes, sir.
It's available, right?
Yes, sir.
This is the latest product which has been provided by one of the platform service providers. This is called as the interactive forms. Okay. In the market, it is being sold by the name as AARI, Automation Anywhere Robotic Interface. Now notice what is happening in this, the brief description that we just had about a person interacting with the call center, how this has been now taken care of in this new particular technology.
Customers, they must to get the status.
So if you notice over here, a customer data exists in multiple locations. So if I call up a call center, what happens is that there are multiple sources of data from which the call center person has to retrieve the information, and very frequently they tell us, sir, the system is taking a little bit of more time than expected. Could you please hold on to the line, right? Actually, they are trying to reach out to multiple systems to gather the necessary piece of information to service us. Now, if you notice over here, 3 minutes is the average time for every call.
Why? Okay. Because customer data exists in multiple applications. When a customer calls the status of his order and to complain why it's late, the front office, he then looks in the Oracle data and connects to FedEx. Rep goes through this process. Resolution rates. Anywhere changes that by enabling the rep to see all the data he needs.
Now, this is the basic information that you require when somebody, a call center representative requires when somebody is calling them to service. Now, the case taken over here is related to some specific order processing. So when a person calls in, you take the first name and the last name, and now you see what happens after this.
It's on one screen. Without having to toggle between applications, enabling the rep to spend that time on improving the customer experience. Let's walk through it.
On the right hand side of the screen over here, this is the form that has been built using the tool, which is Automation Anywhere currently in this case. It is their product. Now, what is happening is that instead of the call center person enabling 2-3 different applications, they log into 2-3 different applications to fetch a certain set of data, they will only access this particular form. Okay, and now you see what happens.
Demo of how we make this possible for our users. You see this form in front of you. Looks simple and easy to understand. Not unlike the forms you fill in every day. Except this has a superpower. When the agent fills in the first and last name of the customer that just called in, the remaining form fills in automatically.
Over here on the bottom, if you notice, this is the bot that has started execution. What this bot is doing is that instead of the agent logging into multiple applications to fetch the data for this customer, the bot behind the screens is actually going ahead and doing this work for the agent. And the agent is currently talking to the customer.
Automatically. With the other info, so the agent can bring up in seconds all the information he needs.
This data which is getting filled is being filled up by the bot
for the customer on the phone, and it's a breeze to create.
And I'm sorry,
seconds
this is the place where they are showcasing, I'll skip this step, this is the place where they are showcasing how quickly anybody can build this particular form.
Users drag and drop elements into a form and easily connect a bot to each element. This allows the form to pull data from multiple systems and present it to the agent on one.
Here, there is the list of bots that the person has created, which they can give it to the agent. So what the agent gets is the front-end form that you just saw a few screens back.
Data can be picked up from all sources, Microsoft applications, and handwritten via our award-winning IQBot solution. Now, these forms work the other way as well.
Now, notice the same form. The previous example was to extract data from multiple sources. What if somebody wants to update their phone number? Some client wants to update his phone number. The same form can actually be utilized to update the phone number of the client across multiple systems in the background, but the call center doesn't have to have access to any of those systems. This form will do all the work in the background.
If the customer wants to update his address, the agent can type it in the form. A submit button will update the customer's address in all applications connected to the form. Agents can use one form or multiple forms based on the task in front of them. Once created, these forms can be deployed to one agent or all agents immediately through A2019's role.
So now you can correlate what is happening and how the complete technology gamut is changing. A person who was trying to do multiple things and has to be accurate to remember the user ID, passwords and everything, and to do the things manually, everything is now at the fingertips of this particular person. That's how the call centers are now changing with these intelligent solutions. Now, during this discussion, the guy who was speaking briefly touched base onto something called as intelligent automation, that is the IQBot. I'll just show you what happens in IQBot and what exactly is IQBot all about. Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So here I have got a profit and loss statement of few companies which are different. Definitely the profit and loss statement, though the contents are the same, the formats can be different the way they want to present it. Now the challenge which was shared across with us that we receive such kind of forms from 2,500 companies and we want to take out the data for our analysis. Now let's see how does an intelligent solution help these kind of business challenges. Here we are showcasing the profit and loss statement format. This is how the intelligent bot environment looks like. Now, if you notice, there is something called as learning instances on the left hand side. This is exactly the area where we touched base very briefly about what do you mean by training the bot. So this is basically where the training happens. If you notice this training percentage. And one of the most important and critical things in these kind of training is accuracy. If the accuracy is less, you better have to take a go ahead from the business that this kind of accuracy is acceptable. Again, another key thing to notice over here that the developer has not done a single piece of coding over here. It is all drag drop. Here the developer is specifying which are the fields that I want to extract from that particular document, plain vanilla English. on this particular section where my mouse pointer is, if you noted, upload files max 150. 150 files can be uploaded at same point in time. With the latest version, you can probably 1,000 plus files can be uploaded at one point in time for the bot to analyze. Now here, if you notice, what is happening in the background is something called as the AIML engine, which has come into play. We have to just put up the data, what we want to extract, the documents from where we want to extract, and just let the AIML do its work. Sometimes this particular engine takes a few minutes, sometimes few hours to analyze the data and give up the details. Now notice again, semantic analysis and all, they come into the picture and they are all inbuilt. The blue lines, which are border lines, which are being showcased over here, this is the area where the intelligent bot AIML solution has been able to identify the data. If you want to take out any of these data into your Excel or any other area, you can take out this area. Whatever the bot could not identify or the AIML engine could not identify, it will not be able to highlight with this box. What this person is trying to do over here is that these particulars, if you notice, it is there on the left hand side of box at the corner. If this comes in the middle or there are any other text which comes over here, I want the bot to capture it, because this is just a sample document. There can be other documents in which there can be other kind of details written over here. I want the bot to pick up everything. Again, over here, if you notice, for the year ended, the year has not come over here. For some of the companies, they printed over here only for the year ended 2017. Yeah, they were 31st March 2017 and gone into the next line. I do not want to miss this data, so I'm just extending that area of the data to cover both the data sets. See. Now, if you look the preview, I'm previewing it, whatever changes I have made, whether the bot is able to recognize all those data sets or not. Below, I can see the preview also immediately. Finally, this will be the output that will be given to the RPA bot. This is the cognitive bot. Now this particular toggle button has sent the bot directly from the training to the staging environment, and from there it will go into the production environment. Now see, it is going into production. It's as simple as this. And the best part, whatever activities we did over there, AIML, semantic analysis, you can see the number of lines of code written over here automatically by the bot. You can upload any number of profit and loss statements and it will give you the output. Now we are trying to execute the bot and take the output into a particular format at a specified path, and that gives me the output of the cognitive bot. The bot is getting executed on the right hand side bottom, you just saw. This is the output that has been prepared by the bot, and that's the output which we have, and we can now utilize it for the next steps. So this particular multiple format PNL statement output via an intelligent bot, completely designed in less than 15-20 minutes, and the output is there. Now the same thing if I want to do with normal RPA solutions or any other technology will take good amount of time. I'll showcase few more demos to you. One of the last probably demos that I would like to showcase, any of these solutions in the market have got few components that we need to be aware about. When we say intelligent process automation, I discussed majorly about the OCR. All these companies across the globe have something called as ABI OCR, one of the prominent companies in the OCR technologies, inbuilt in their solutions. There is one free OCR that is Tesseract OCR, which is also available. It all varies which kind of OCR do you want to use in your solution, because you need to be always worried about the accuracy of these OCR solutions to extract the data. So intelligent data processing is the key area that IPA is currently focusing upon, because once the data is extracted, you can do anything with that data. I'm just briefing you on what exactly these platforms have in common. There is a development environment where you develop all these bots, intelligent bot, normal bot. There is a server where you deploy these bots. And there is a runtime environment where these bots actually work on a daily basis. A very brief video on how these all coordinate with each other will be completed in a minute or so. Is this visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
The heartbeat of Automation Anywhere's enterprise control room. Here,
please do not go by the name of the product or anything. It's basically the server, what we call it as the control room, nothing else. Each and every product has got a server. What this server does is controls the licenses, controls the bots. Tomorrow, any audit comes, you can take out any kind of data from these servers.
Human beings centrally manage and deploy the industry's most sophisticated RPA bots. The platform is architected to be horizontally scalable to meet every RPA deployment need.
The topmost one is the creator, where you actually create the bots. Rest all are the runtime environments. No code will be there. They will be utilized only for the execution of the bots. One key difference between these platforms and the Antworks platform that I had highlighted, the only platform available in the market, when you install a runner on one of the machines, desktop, laptop, or anything, or a VM, you can install only one runner. Now, if I want to install two runners on the same machine so that two different processes can be executed at the same time, I cannot do that with any of the tools in the market other than Antworks.
Everything is made easy, from building a proof of concept to scaling your RPA implementation. It is one of many industry firsts. Bot capacity and the way bots are deployed is managed with a load balancer. The system supports single sign-on via Active Directory and SAML 2.0 standards. Automation Anywhere provides...
These all features what are being described over here are out of the box available with all the products. One of the key things to notice, and the only facility available with this particular product, Automation Anywhere, is that today I have got a sudden increase in my business due to a Diwali weekend, and I want extra set of bots because the order inflow is very high. I want to process them all on time. I can purchase the bots from the cloud only for a limited period at a specified price. I can implement them, and after that, the bots will not be of any use. For I require these bots for the next 15 days, I can only purchase the bots for the next 15 days. No other service platform provider in the market has given that particular facility. How do you ensure standardization is one of the areas that we looked at with so much amount of automation? How do you ensure that the automation is happening properly? Copy paste the signed off code of the first bot into the second bot, and your second bot is up and live. As simple as that. No changes required.
Provides rigorous version control functionality like check in, check out, version comparison, and rollback. The architecture supports the dev, test, and production configuration within separate environments to support SDLC best practices for enterprises. Most importantly, it can be configured for high availability and disaster recovery, providing redundancy not only at the server or control room level, but also at the client or bot runner level.
if you have implemented a complete automation setup in India, you can have a replica of that setup anywhere across the globe or in India itself, and no other changes are to be made to the code or the environment.
Bot Farm uniquely delivers the ability to spin up bot runners.
This is exactly what I just spoke about. I require extra bots to be made available to me. I can just purchase them. Within an hour, the bots will be made available once the payment is done, and I can utilize the bots for that specified period for which I have purchased them.
On demand, to address fluctuations in bot capacity requirements, using compute capacity only as needed, then spins them down again instantly in your private data center or public cloud. Automation Anywhere Enterprise is renowned for its bank-grade security. It is relied upon by more banks and financial institutions than any other RPA provider in the world. It's bulletproof.
So there is data which is currently in motion. That is, the data is traveling from one machine to another machine, or from the client machine to the server, or the data that is stored in the database. So these particular data sets are always encrypted and nobody can hack into this particular data. All these solutions are provided out of the box from all the service providers.
Proof, providing best-in-class security with AES 256 for data at rest and TLS 1.2 for data in motion. It's the industry's most stringent role-based access control for the bot repository. Bot runners and all critical admin and management functions is an essential feature, enabling you to segregate duties by separating the authority for creating bots and the authority to actually run bots. You can only create bots within the repository space to which you have access and only run them on machines which you are authorized to use. By supporting the best practice of principle of least privilege, you can implement airtight security on your RPA platform. We support Kerberos and NTLM-based authentication. Other security features unique to Automation Anywhere include comprehensive non-reputable auditing, secure recording for sensitive data, stealth mode for running bots, and credential vault with RBAC-based locker and...
One of the critical elements in the insurance and the banking industry is that when you are recording something with the help of the tools, I do not want any sensitive information of the client or accounts to be recorded. So all these data, I can mark it as sensitive and everything will get masked. So even if you are standing in front of the laptop or the desktop and the bot is in operation, you'll not be able to see any data. You'll only be able to see the screen and the movement of the bot. Stealth mode is a military grade word that has been used over here. That means hidden bots. So basically, if you are running the bots on a particular machine, I can do the environment settings in such a manner that nobody will be able to recognize and realize that in the background, the bots are actually getting used, executed, so that nobody is interrupting with the bots and the bots stop executing. So that's why the stealth mode. I'll just go back. Any queries till now? I'll again go back to the presentation. I've got few slides more.
Hello, sir. Do you think that intelligent automation is a threat to human being?
I don't think so that intelligent automation is a threat to the human being, because if you notice over here, there are two parts to it. One is the normal RPA and the second is the intelligent automation. Again, if you notice in the intelligent automation, we have got AI/ML, and again, the code for the AI/ML is written in a restrictive manner. It's not a it utilizes deep learning, but not in an unattended mode. So there are two modes of the deep learning that can be used. The unattended mode is the dangerous one. The attended mode, where you know exactly what kind of changes are being made by the system to the data and it is able to take an action, is something which is basically there, which is called as the supervised mode. Unsupervised mode or an unattended mode is something which, yeah, we should be, worrying about. It's a worrying phase, because Facebook tried it and it failed miserably, where the machines were actually taking decisions by itself and it went out of control. They had to plug out those machines, basically. So yes, currently the facilities which are being made available, they are all in a controlled manner. So till now, we do not find any kind of threat to the human beings or any kind of work-related aspects. Because if you notice the kind of implementations also which are being done, people want to take control. They still do not want to leave everything to the bots. One of the banks, leading banks, ANZ Grindlay's bank, they have got some 4,000 bots which are working in their environment. So you can understand the kind of dependency that they have created on these machines. 4,000 is a huge number. People cannot scale beyond 50, 60 bots, in fact, till this day. They have got 4,000, the only one in India, basically. And still, they have not gone for an unsupervised machine learning kind of an implementation with RPA, which will be very dangerous, yes.
Okay. Sir, is there any negative aspects of IA?
Again, it's a IA is a top layer on which base layer is still the ML, in fact, which is working. It's how we implement it is something that needs to be looked at. So people are still talking about the positive sides. How do you want to implement the ML so that the artificial intelligence can take its decisions properly? Yes. Varying effects are there, definitely, but most of it, as I said, is in a controlled manner till now. Industry has still not utilized it in an uncontrolled manner where, for example, and Watson, which has been implemented, again, it has been implemented in a controlled manner, being accessed by multiple companies across India and the globe. The impact is it has been used for nearly a decade now. No adverse effects per se for the artificial intelligence solution till now. I give you some examples of Myntra. They are using this artificial intelligence solution for designing dress designers. In fact, there are some medical areas also where artificial intelligence is being used. But if you notice a pattern, most of the places the artificial intelligence which is being used is for the predictive analysis. Most of the places, nothing more than that as of now. Weather patterns, everything it is being fed to the systems for more accurate predictive analysis, which is the most commonly used algorithm, basically.
Sir, am I compromising my data privacy?
So if you again notice over here during the presentation, there was some kind of a discussion related to on your private data center. Now, yes, despite of all these data centers or your data being there with you in the inside your environment, I as a service provider, I can tell you I'm working with a leading bank. And for doing some proof of concepts, I have got the data sets of some of their clients. Though I have got an NDA, but the question is that it is available with me. Somebody hacks into my system or I accidentally upload it or make it available somewhere, none of these most sophisticated systems or NDAs or legalities in place will also be able to save the day for anybody, in fact. So yes, this still remains a question as to how do we ensure that the data is not compromised. But most of the time, if you notice, it is still being compromised by the human beings rather than by the systems by themselves, in fact. The hackers are taking the big basket thing. The hackers took out the data. Big basket never exposed it. So it's a lack of security over there because of which that data got exposed. In fact.
So it is as same as that of using the intelligent bots.
See, intelligent bots is more like it's an in-house environment where you're trying to cull out some data from various different data sets for your various business processes. And these data is going to reside on your system. There are two areas where you will notice that there are major challenges. One, the maximum fraud and thefts have actually been done by the internal employees first, because they have got accesses to the data. That is one. And second, it is because of the security related loopholes, the second way in which the data has been compromised. So now here in these two, the first one, that is the data compromised by the human beings who are working in the organization, is the number one, if you notice the trends in the market. And second is, of course, this hacking and all, the more strengthened, the more security is better for these, the better is your data saved in the inside the organization. Now with this pandemic, most of the organizations are moving to cloud. And the security is on the topmost agenda. They are all setting up their private cloud, one-to-one access to the environment at Azure or Amazon or Google. But again, they are doing multiple rounds of testing throughout the day to ensure that the data is not compromised. But yes, you are right. I can still take out the data in the way I want to if I know the way.
Okay.
But the bots by themselves will not take out any data and send it anywhere, because I have not coded it the way that it can think of its own.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Very quick look at banking and financial services. I will probably, Shankar sir, I will probably pass on this deck at a later time to you so that you can share it across for any further queries. A quick look at the standardized processes versus, you know, complexity of the processes that can be standardized. If you notice KYC AML process, card account interchange and settlement process, why this is a complex process? People from the banking domain have been doing this exchange element throughout the day or on an hourly basis. The challenge is multiple APIs from multiple banks are involved and multiple partners are involved. If I want to automate this process to understand and collate this data and make a sensible information out of it, it's a very complex process for me to actually automate. Tax claims management, various different documents in various different formats. I need multiple layers of intelligence to actually ensure that this data is correctly taken out so that I can take it ahead for processing. So these are the various areas in banking where the people from the banking domain are trying to automate their processes. Quickly, I will touch on two slides. One is this company called Antworks. What you can notice, this is their RPA bot. This is their intelligent bot. Naming conventions are different. Okay. I briefly discussed on this. This is the only platform where you can put up multiple bots on a single machine, saving on infrastructure cost. This is the only company in the market which has got its own OCR solution. Yes, they do not depend on Abby or a Google OCR or a Microsoft OCR. They have got their own intelligent OCR solution built. A scientist has built it, who has worked with NASA and other companies, and he has built it for them. Automation Anywhere, one of the leading again in the market. Now, if you notice, this is their intelligent bot, the IQ bot. This is their analytics bot. This is their normal RPA bot. And this is the latest addition to the kitty, that is the process discovery bot. So UiPath, what they are trying to do is that, or process discovery bot of Automation Anywhere, what they are trying to do is that after the process discovery, can I build a bot by itself? So basically the intelligent algorithm should be able to build a bot of whatever it has studied the process. They have not been successful. A very skeleton bot automatically gets built, but no business logic and iterations they have been able to put it. They may come out with that kind of bots in the near future. So you do not require any service provider. Put up the bot. Bot will discover, it will automate, and it will implement. Simple. Maybe 2021 would be the year where they will try to do something like this. UiPath, they took over that Process Gold as one of the company which I showcased. With the help of that, they have been able to give this task capture as one of the solutions. This is their server orchestrator. This is their business insights, the analytics engine, and this is the designer studio. So task capture has got two different aspects. One, I implement it on every machine, and whatever the user is doing, it gets captured. Second, I've got multiple software in the, let's say a SAP, a Finacle, and multiple other software in the company. I implement a process discovery or a process mining tool at the server level. It looks at everything in the organization from the process perspective, draws out which particular processes are taking the most amount of time. Example, I'll give output as an example. You must have seen banks advertising, open an account with us in less than 2 minutes. How are they able to open an account in less than 2 minutes? Because there are multiple background checks that you are required to do as per RBI. So, if I am able to advertise this, that means my solutions in the background are able to service me to that capacity. Now, if I find that regularly I am able to open bank accounts, but they are getting stretched to 4.5 minutes. Where is 2.5 minutes going extra? Because I have already advertised that open it in 2 minutes. So now the process mining tool comes into the picture, and out of all these service providers, only UiPath has got that tool via Process Gold. So the name of the activity is process mining. Once the application hits the bank, the process mining can traverse the complete route of the application and tell you which particular desk, which particular activity it is taking more than the expected time, and which is the easier way out. That also it guides because of its AI/ML algorithm. If you want to automate it, you have to automate it using all the other features which are available. Mining tool can only tell you where are the problems. Once your processes have got automated, the mining tool can still keep a track whether your processes are giving you the output which you had desired from the automation. It's a very costly tool. Indian rupees, it is like 75 lakh worth of just the tool cost. You require data mining experts to implement that tool in the first quarter in a 4 to 6 months time frame, and then it starts giving the output. But once it starts giving the output, you'll be rich with quality data and exact areas where you require the processes to be automated. Any queries that I can take more, because I think I am hitting the timeline. Yeah. Sankar sir, do I have some more time, or we need to close because it's already 11:43 or 11:45? Let me know.
It's going to be 45. Can we conclude? The next session speaker is waiting. That's what.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
No issues. Fine, sir. So you let me know any kind of other queries that I can address. I may not be able to take it right now because of the time constraint, but I'll be more than happy to connect offline. I can share across more details on any of your areas of interest or any specific queries that might help you address your challenge areas.
Shankar, sir, shall we?
Thank you.
It was a very wonderful session, sir, on intelligent automation, and we got to know what are the processes which are automated and how they are automated, and how to deal with structured and unstructured datas, and how intelligent automation can be done using live use cases and to extract data from multiple sources using interactive forms. It was a very fruitful session, sir. Hoping to hear many more sessions from you in future. May God bless you. Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot, ma'am. And thanks a lot.